What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today is a very special day. Guys, we are finally getting fish for our 8,000 gallon monster pond. Now, the fish I plan on getting today aren't gonna be in here long term, but they're gonna help get our tank cycle for the future monster that we have. So, what I was thinking is that we head to my buddy Steve's place, the paddlefish expert, and get some awesome koi, some awesome carp, and maybe even a few paddlefish for our pond to get it cycled and going before we get these monster fish in the next couple of weeks. Now, if you watched Monday's video, you would know that our pond actually had a tiny leak in it, which we did have fixed, but the pond is empty. So I need to go ahead and start filling it up before we head to Steve's. That way, when we get back with these fish, we have about a foot of water in here, and then the pond will take another couple days to fill up, but they should be fine until then.
Watch how easy it is to start filling up our pond. All you have to do is come over here, grab the switch, flip it up, and boom, we got water just like that.
And now it's time to head to the paddlefish place. All right, guys, we just pulled up to the paddlefish and koi place, and it is currently about 30 degrees here in Kentucky. We picked the coldest day to do this. Last week it was about 70. So today we're gonna freeze our butts off.
All right, we're ready to go. We're getting in the pond right now, and we're gonna be selecting out the nicest fish we can for our pond to help get this thing cycle. After that, we're gonna be getting the paddlefish, which is gonna be awesome, and probably one of the most unique fish I've ever got to work with. All right, guys, so what we're doing right now is Steve is currently taking this giant net, and we're just basically gonna walk the whole pond. There is thousands of fish in this concrete pond right here. And so with this net, it has a catch at the bottom of it, which is gonna catch all these fish. And basically we'll be able to hand select whatever we want for our pond. This is kind of sketchy. It's gonna be so cold.
You can get all the way to that corner. I think we got a few.
Holy cow.
The water's starting to turn.
Oh my gosh. I think we caught the mother one. Oh.
This has both hybrid koi, and goldfish are mixed in here.
All right, guys, so for those of you who don't know, this is Steve, profound paddlefish expert. He's been doing this for 40 years now and kind of a mentor to me. I think you were the first person that pretty much ever sold me a paddlefish, and you just also sold me the platinum paddlefish that you saw, which was, I mean, that was really a one-of-a-kind fish. But I want him to talk a little bit about what these fish are and basically his experience in the aquaculture and as well as fish keeping.
So what we have here is a couple different species. This is just a normal goldfish. We have koi, which also are really nice for the garden pond.
And guys, Steve also sells all these fish, so if you're ever wanting to buy these fish, I'm gonna have his stuff linked below where y'all can contact me. I mean, there's thousands and thousands of fish in here. And then behind us, he has some giant paddlefish that would be amazing to stock your big pond at your house. So if y'all want that, please hit us up and we can make that happen.
So you don't see any color. This is actually a cross with a koi and a goldfish. And the reason we produced this was for weed control in ponds. These fish, I call them the pigs of the pond, because they actually root around in the pond mud eating worms and also the filamentous algae and duckweed that floats on.
That's not a fish you can just buy everywhere, right? Like, you all pretty much created that species of fish.
We're the only one in the state actually selling these fish, yes.
And this is why you don't release your pet goldfish as well. So, you know, a lot of times you see at the store, you see those little tiny goldfish. Well, these guys, they're not even full grown, are they, at this size? And so they get huge and they can really be destructive to ecosystems. Look at the face on this fish right here. When I talk about how unique they are, look how beautiful these are. And these are just your common koi. Obviously there's Japanese koi too that get a lot more expensive. But for the price on these guys, I feel like they're probably one of the coolest fish. You know, these aren't like they're $100, you know, you're talking
$10.
Yeah, 10 bucks. So I think they're really cool and a great fish for really anybody, whether you're an expert in fish keeping or whether you're just getting your first pond or tank. We're gonna get more, we're gonna keep selecting and looking at more of the other carp in here, but we'll get back with you all in just a second. All right, guys, we gotta fill our bucket up. Here, watch your legs, watch your legs. That's how we fill our bucket up here. Oh my God. Fire hydrant. All right, guys, so now that we have all our koi and goldfish in the truck, it is now time to catch these paddlefish. So this is the baby paddlefish pond. Over there is where all the giants are. But this is the juveniles that Steve actually bred here. Actually, Predatory Fence has these on their website, these exact paddlefish from Steve on here. So if you want to buy those, you
You can buy them from Predatory Fins, super easy. But Steve's gonna feed them right now, and we're gonna try to net them without getting in the pond because we are frozen. We're gonna watch them come up right here and get these floating pellets, and we're just gonna grab them with the net and hopefully get a couple of them to show you guys.
All right, here we go.
There you go.
We got a few, but
look how cool these guys are. This is probably one of my favorite fish. You can see that dark melanistic color. Just a little baby, and they'll get 4 or 5 feet. I think the record is like 180 pounds. So these have a long way to go, but really just a prehistoric fish that is just one of the coolest fish on earth, in my opinion. So we're gonna take these to the bucket right now and get them acclimated. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Look at how fat that fish is. It is so chunky. I can't wait to show you all the big ones. Actually, next month, we're going to bring some up to Ohio Fish Rescue and Brian Barcheck. So that's going to be really cool, and I can't wait to bring you on that experience in April. Okay, so we got 25 goldfish and 10 paddlefish. Thank you so much, Steve.
You're welcome.
It's a pleasure.
Anytime. Come back.
Yeah, we'll be back very soon to get those paddlefish for that display I was telling about. That's going to be really cool for Brian Barcheck and Ohio Fish Rescue. So I can't wait to be back very soon. And then hopefully get a platinum.
We'll see what we can do this spring.
All right, baby. We just got all the fish for the warehouse. I can't wait to get there. This is going to be the first ever fish added to the 8,000-gallon pond. We got some sick paddlefish, some sick koi and goldfish. As you all saw, I was freezing, but now I'm warmed up. I'm ready to go, and I can't wait to bring you all along to see these fish in this tank. All right, guys. We just made it in the warehouse right now, and I'm going to go inside and check out how our tank is looking. We were filling up earlier this morning, but I want to see what that water height is before we add these fish. This is the moment of truth. Come on in, let's check it out. All right, the pond actually looks pretty good right now. We have about a foot of water in there, which will be perfect for these fish. I'm probably gonna have to let it fill overnight. Unfortunately, this thing is filling a little bit slower than I would like, but this water is super clean and it is actually freezing, which will be perfect for these fish. We probably won't even have to acclimate them. I almost forgot the most important thing. So right here we have my dechlorinator. This is a huge bucket of Seachem Safe. And this is how I dechlorinate this water. So it's such a large water mass. We need to use this powder because it's a higher concentrate. I need 8 tablespoons. I'm gonna kind of eyeball it, probably do that. More is always okay. I'd rather do more than do less, especially this time of year, because in the springtime, your all's water systems, if you're on city water, they're putting more chloramines, chlorine in the water. So it is very important that you add extra this time of year. So all we have to do, disperse that like so. We'll get maybe one more little scoop here. And this stuff is actually a pretty good bang for your buck. So I'm gonna take it like this and just toss it all everywhere. And then once we get that water mixed in, it'll mix it all in there and it'll be safe for the fish before we add it. We're having to improvise today, it's just me. So we're gonna get these fish in here and just start tossing them in. Look at all that, look at all those fish in there. Holy cow. It's time, guys, the moment's here. The fish are ready to go in the pond. I'm not even gonna acclimate them because their water is very, very similar. I'm more than hyped up right now. Let's put a paddlefish in there, that's so fitting. Look at that. That is so insane. That long spoon. All right, we're gonna toss them in there nice and gently, like so. There he goes. The first fish in the 8,000-gallon pond. That is so insane. This is the first fish, guys, in the 8,000-gallon pond. It looks so insane. Look how much space he's gonna have. So much room. Once this pond gets completely filled up, it's gonna look so insane. Let's see if we can see through the panel right there. Oh my goodness. So insane. All right, next one, we're gonna add one of these goldfish in there. Super pretty. Off you go, little buddy. As you all can tell, I've been waiting for this moment 6 months, guys. After I lost all my fish, like, this just feels so surreal right now to have new fish in our new pond. I cannot wait for what can come in this pond, guys. I hope y'all are just as excited as I am. I just, right now, I want to prioritize the health of these fish and make sure they all get in there okay. It's that big, chunky paddlefish. This is a giant, guys. Look at this. That's the biggest fish going in our pond so far. Oh my goodness. Ooh. That's the pond monster for now, but within the next few weeks, guys, that will probably be the smallest fish in this pond. This is a prime example of those goldfish hybrids. Look at this nice big mouth right here. They're perfect for eating algae, and they're gonna do really good in this pond for the time being because they'll eat off any of the algae on the glass. These are like
a pleco on steroids. Pleco are one of the worst fish for cleaning your tank. They actually make them dirtier. But if you're really looking for something that's gonna clean up your pond, I highly suggest getting some type of goldfish with a nice big sucker mouth like that. Check this out. I just finished adding all the fish in here. Look, they're already all schooling up, all the paddlefish, all these koi carp. Oh my goodness. So what I wanna do, since our pond isn't currently filled up yet, I wanna come back in about 12 hours when this thing is filled up all the way to the top. I wanna go grab my swim trunks. I'm gonna grab my GoPro. I'm gonna hop in the pond and swim with all the fish and give you all an up close look of how sick this pond really looks. We're back, baby. The fish are looking awesome. The tank is completely filled up and it's time to get in it. This sucks so bad. This water is like 45 degrees right now. Fight with it. I just want y'all to remember, I do this for you guys. We literally read every single comment every single week. So every time y'all show love, like, it just fires us up so much to make the best content out there for you all. Like this right now, it's 11 o'clock, I got work in the morning, and I'm literally in this pond that's 45 degrees, and I'm about to go snorkeling for y'all, so that way y'all can see underwater footage of these fish. Dude, look at my foot, bro. It's turning purple. Is that normal? Can you see that?
You gotta get in now.
All right, I hope y'all enjoy this footage. That's the end of the video today, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. We finally have fish in the 8,000 gallon pond. I can't wait to see what's to come. Please make sure to subscribe, like, show us some love, guys. We're working so hard on these videos for you all, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.